at the Luba Garifuna Museum this afternoon on Fern Lane, Garifuna elder Sebastian Cayetano has put up a memorial to his friend and pastor, the late Father John Stochl.
This is the bag, Father Stochl's personal bag, that he contributed to the Luba Garifuna Museum here, 24th May 2006. And in this bag, he gave me these booklets, Familia Gumfaliti, Holy Family in Garifuna. And this was the first publication, Lubener Seal, dating back 1951. Father Stochl, Theodore Palacio, Canada Arzu, and many of the Garifuna St. John's College students at that time. Okay. Then here is this very, very impressive letter written by Ted Palacio to Father Stochl, Barranco British Honorius, 3rd January 1952.
And around the corner at St. Martin de Porres Parish Church, current pastor Father Matthew Rule describes the former Jesuit mission superior, pastor, and educator as a man of the people, whose example other Belizean Jesuits were expected to follow.
He was beloved. That's what he was. When I got here, people said, Father, we need you to get out like Father Stochl. We need you to get out and around like Father Stochl. And so Stochl had a bike, and fortunately I like bikes too, so I take his example and I do what the people tell me, but he was a man of the people. He was truly a man of the people.
For Caetano, Father Stochl was a friend to the Garifuna people, among the first to tap into the rich potential of their unique culture.
Father Stochl became acquainted with our Garinagu boys, students, way back from 1950s. In 1951, Ted Palacio, Canada Arzu, and the rest of them wrote Lubener Seelo, the first Garifuna catechism produced by Father Stochl and St. John's College boys, way back then. Around 1999-2000, we established the Garifuna Choir, Belize City Garifuna Choir, along with my uncle Theodore Palacio, along with Father Stochl. And then Father Stochl was so much in love with our music that he decided to dedicate third Sunday of the month to the Garifuna Choir. It's a Garifuna English Mass that we celebrate at St. Martin's on third Sunday. And even up to now, we still celebrate the third Sunday Garifuna Mass at St. Martin's.
Aaron Humes reporting for News 5.